Hi everyone. Welcome to today's stream with the Garnish Network, Garnish Schools Worldwide. My name's Amir Yacoub. I am a teacher on the Logic and the Mixing course specifically, though some of our longer courses over in London, which is where I'm joining for you from today. Thank you for joining me. Today I'm going to be taking you through sampling, which is taught as part of our Logic module in longer courses or our Logic short course. And I'm going to kind of show you what my approach is to sampling, you know, how you would do it technically inside of Logic, and all of that good stuff. So without further ado, I will show you my screen, which looks like that. Yeah, exactly. And what I'm going to start off by saying is sampling is obviously quite key to the backbone of many different art forms or genres of music, should I say. And I would say one of them is an art form or music form that I grew up on, which was hip hop. So I'm heavily inspired by a lot of hip hop music. In my production, I tend to make stuff that is kind of like hip hop inspired, but, you know, still has like soulful elements and stuff like that. And it can generally border towards, you know, more on the pop sphere of things from time to time as well. Just depends on what mood I'm in. So I'm going to find out what mood I'm in today with you guys as well. I do welcome all of you and I do thank you for all your time. Be sure to check out Garnish Schools, obviously the one here in London. I'm not at that one. I'm around the corner from it. This is my own studio. We've got obviously sites in New York, San Fran, LA, all of those kind of places, and other parts of the world as well. So without much further of ado, I'm just going to jump in. So Logic is probably like my personal favorite DAW. It's the one I've known the longest, I use other DAWs as well. But this is something that you would kind of see as part of our Logic course, as I said before. So I have a blank session loaded up here, and I've picked out a sample that I'm going to work with, because I'm going to show you a few different ways of working, and I'm going to try and dive as deep as I can into you know, how you can approach working, actually just working with samples. And the one that I've chosen today is actually a one by my favorite group, the Isley Brothers. So with samples, for you guys who don't know, just you can go in and you can drag and drop, which is what I'm going to do there. I'm just going to drag and drop that one in. You can load samples also if you use the file browser here. You can go to all files and you can load samples from there, various points, like if you've got different drives connected like I have there or whatever, like, you know, you can find your samples wherever you need to find them. There are third-party things that can make helping find your samples better, but we're going to try and keep it just strictly Logic today. I'm going to pretend that you don't know anything apart from Logic. Okay, so I have a sample here. It's from a Isley Brothers song called The Highways of My Love, and it's something that I actually sampled on vinyl a long time ago, I've just kind of pulled it up today. So what I'm going to do first is I'm just going to try and tidy this up, just this beginning bit here. So any audio file you have in Logic, you can just go to the bottom left hand or right hand corner and you can essentially trim it. That's going to be important because, like, you want your audio sample when you're sampling particularly to kind of just start bang on the transient if you can, like, and kind of zooming in there. I left a bit of space, but, you know, it wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. But, you know, just to be clean and tidy, I'm gonna do that. That's a very tiny, tiny space there. One thing I'm gonna do as well is I'm gonna kind of make the waveform view bigger, just by going up here and clicking this button here next to where it says drag overlap, and you can kind of see I can kind of easily see where my points are, and various things are going to happen. So what I'm going to do is we're just going to listen to this sample, just because we should. So here we go. Okay, and you can see, like, I stopped recording from my record player when the actual music kind of comes in, because that was the only part that I wanted to record of that song. I think pretty sure in that folder I've got another snippet of that song. But no matter where you get your samples from, you might get them from vinyl, you might get them from CD, you know, all of this kind of stuff. Like, wherever you're getting it from. Some people even get them from YouTube, you know, which is, I mean, it's up to you, whatever you want to do. I think one thing that you need to be aware of is you're going to kind of have to know how to count some bars. That's a pretty big prerequisite of sampling, particularly when you're working in Logic. So my first approach here is that maybe I just love the first two or the first four bars, and I'm really going to try and just kind of just take that and use it as it is, right? And, you know, on the face of things, it kind of seems easy. It kind of seems like simple. It kind of seems, oh yeah, you just take that and you do it. But then when you want to add other instruments, you're going to kind of have to make sure everything else is in time with that. And, you know, you're going to start to run into problems if you don't approach it in the correct way. So your first approach is always going to be, what do I want to take? So for ease here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this track by pressing Command D. And I'm going to drag this down. I'm going to leave that sample there untouched up top, because I'm going to have to come back to it later on, just to show you a few other bits. So I'm just going to leave that up there untouched for now. So this is my kind of, like, you know, I'm going to extract a two or a four bar loop from here. I haven't quite decided what I want to do with it yet. So I'm going to go and press play, and then I'm just going to count along. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3. Just basic counting of rhythms and bars and beats and all of that kind of stuff. And I'm going to kind of take note of how much of it I'm taking. So 2, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 7, 2, 3, 4, 8, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so I'm just going to take the first eight. No, in fact, just to keep it simple, I'm going to take the first four. So let's count that together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4. And what I want to do is I want to take this audio file and I want to chop it basically right before the next downbeat, which is actually where my playhead is at the moment. Now, you may or may not know that in Logic, what you can do is you can have an extended control bar, or a toolbar, should I say, and that button there will activate that. And in there, you can just go to split regions or events at playhead. Now, I've got this region selected, and it should just go bang like that. There is also a command for that, which is Command T. So that's that there. Yeah.